I have owned the Panasonic GH5 now for over 5 months, and I have used it predominantly for shooting real estate video. Here's my thoughts. Hi, I'm Grant, and I am shooting this video on the backyard of our house. I've had a bit of a busy summer, and you can see we're having a bit of a dry summer here by how brown the lawn is. It needs a bit more sprinkler action on there. So before I get into talking about my thoughts on using this camera for shooting real estate video, I thought I'd show you some footage from the last couple of months. I purchased the GH5 back in October 2017 in three lenses. I got the Panasonic 8-18, or the Panasonic Leica 8-18, the Panasonic 12-35mm f2.8 and 35-100 f2.8. But essentially the main lens that I use, especially for shooting real estate video, is the 8-18. You'll be able to hear the kids playing on the trampoline down there, I apologize for that. There is no doubt that the Panasonic GH5 is a fantastically spec'd camera for shooting video. It's got things such as 4K, high frame rate recording, log format recording, audio in, audio monitoring, and a lot more. You can read the many reviews there are on this camera out there on the interwebs, but I thought I'd just touch on a few of the main things that are essential for me in my job shooting real estate video. I guess first and foremost is actually the picture quality and the ease of use. There is no doubting that picture quality is fantastic. I still shoot predominantly in 1080p, and this camera is fantastic for that actually. A lot of cameras or more modern cameras now are essentially being tuned to shoot in 4K, so when you're shooting 1080, the 1080 is not so great, such as my Inspire with its X5 camera. However, the GH5 still shoots really nice 1080p format pictures, and that's still my predominant format that I use due to my editing system, my workflow, and my client delivery systems. I have to say though, it's been actually quite a steep learning curve for this camera. I'm quite familiar with Canon's, which is what I'm shooting this one on, and the Sony picture menu, so it's taking me a fair bit of time to get used to the Panasonic GH5 menu. It has a lot of menu options and a lot of options within the options, so it's taken a fair bit of getting used to in terms of using the camera and setting it up to the way I like it. I still find myself, even today, 5 months down the track, Googling certain characteristics or menu functions that I'm not sure about. The other thing obviously critical for a camera system for shooting real estate video, or shooting any video for that matter, is your lens system. I've got essentially a Canon lens system, so I had to buy, and this is a factor if you're looking at cameras such as the GH5, I had to buy essentially the Micro Four Thirds system. I had a couple which I use on my Inspire, but essentially I had to buy three new lenses, so that's a factor you have to take into account when buying or jumping ship from one brand of camera to another. I know you can get a Metabones or a lens adapter, but I wanted to go with the native lenses, which I always find are probably better optimized for their autofocus and stabilization. Speaking of lenses, I came from the very good Tokina 11-16, which is what I'm shooting this on now on my Canon, and I am using the Panasonic Leica 8-18, which essentially gives me the lovely wide rectilinear look that I'm looking for when shooting real estate interiors. The lens is a bit smaller and it has got a fairly good sort of focus ring, so yeah, I don't have any problems with it. Autofocus. Yes, it is true that autofocus is not that great on the GH5. In fact, it is still better on my trusty Canon 80D, which I'm shooting this on. However, it's not an issue. It's not really a big issue for me or a deal breaker for me, because essentially when I'm shooting professional work or real estate video, I am running manual focus, so I do not have a problem with that for this particular application. Low light performance. It's not a low light shooting monster like the Sony A7S Mark II. However, I'm quite comfortable running this camera up to ISO 1600 when shooting perhaps in dark interiors, and that I have found has been more than enough. The most I've actually had to push it to is ISO 800, and I am still happy with the image quality. And obviously, just jumping back to form factor, it is small. The Micro Four Thirds system and lenses are really small and compact. One advantage of that is using it on gimbals. It is smaller and lighter than perhaps, for example, this Canon 80D with the Takena lens. So therefore, it opens you up or enables you to use different handheld gimbals if that's your thing for shooting real estate. And yeah, it works really well on a Moser Air gimbal, which I am currently using. The other main benefit that I was after for this camera is it can shoot in VLOG, which is Panasonic's log format. Now, I've had really mixed results with this, actually. I struggle a little bit sometimes to see how much more latitude that VLOG is giving me. I don't see it. You might see here in these two pictures here, one just shooting in CineD and one shooting in log. I know this is kind of an extreme example, but I'm not seeing a whole lot extra dynamic range. The VLOG, however, does give you a great base for colouring or colour grading, and you can definitely get a really nice neutral picture out of it. But saying that though, I'm not a colour grading expert, but I am really struggling with the blues and greens when shooting with VLOG. You can see it in some of these pictures here that I kind of ran out of time and patience, and I still was not happy with my blues and greens. No problems with the interior colour. Exterior colours, not so happy with, but that could be me. I haven't dialed into it properly yet. Which brings up an important point, and that's your workflow. Often if you are turning around jobs quite quickly, then you need to be able to turn around great looking footage without having to spend hours color grading or trying to dial into a camera. So yeah, something to consider with this, or in my experience with the GH5. One of the other standout things about the GH5 though is it records in 100 megabit data rate, and I actually have noticed the quality of the picture, especially when doing a light color grade, really holds up a lot nicer than something, for example, like the 80D, which records around the 60 megabits a second as opposed to the 100 megabits a second. So yes, larger file sizes, but I can see the quality difference in the pictures. One other minor gripe I have with this camera is that when shooting in higher frame rates above 50 or 60p, you lose autofocus. Not a big deal breaker for me, but you don't have any audio either. So yeah, not quite sure why. And sometimes, even though the audio I know is no good at high frame rates, it's actually good still to have something there if you wanted to play it back in real speed or real time, for example. I'm struggling with how to wrap this video up and my final thoughts on the GH5. Is it worth twice the amount of money that, for example, the Canon 80D with the Takena 1116 lens is? And I would say no, it's not. However, it's a camera that you can grow into. The more experienced and the more you delve into, the more it's going to reward you. So yes, it's a complex beast, and it is a camera I am enjoying. That's all from me. See you in the next video.